Namaskar students, this video is for class 8 maths and today we are going to start a new chapter called data handling. In our previous class, in class 7, we have learned how to collect and organize data in frequency distribution table and in bar graph. In class 8, first let us revise the important terms which are associated in data handling. Now first, what is data? Data is the collection of facts or information. The initial data which is given to us is unorganized, and this unorganized initial data is called raw data. The raw data thus we have collected is to be arranged in a systematic order like we have done in frequency distribution table. Now what is frequency? Frequency is the number of time a particular entry occurs. Now let us see one example of frequency distribution table. Here, we are having the data of the favorite subject of a group of students. Now, you can see here, we are having the subjects like arts, maths, science, English, and so on. So, first, to form the distribution table, we have to make three columns. First column will contain the subject or the thing which is given to us. Here, the information is about subject, so we will write the heading as subject. The second column will contain tally marks. Tally marks we have learned in class 6. And the third column is the frequency. So here, we have the number of students, so it's written number of students. In the subject column, we will write all the subject which is mentioned over here. We are having arts, maths, science and English. Now you see here, first we are having arts, so we have marked 1 tally over here. Then second we are having maths, so you will mark 1 line in tally. Similarly, you are going to do all the entry of tally mark in this column. Then you will count how many lines you have got. So that will be the number of times, that is the frequency. Now here is the question which says which is the most liked subject. Now the most liked subject is the highest number of frequency. Here you can see it's the number 7. So 7 is for arts. So the most liked subject is arts. And the least liked subject will be the least frequency. Here we are having the number 4. And number 4 is for English. So the least liked subject is English. Similarly, in the same way, you are going to do this, try this sum given on page number 72. Here is the question and you have to form a frequency distribution table. And I think all of you can do this of your own. Now let us see what is group frequency distribution. Now first, let us see one example. In this example, the marks obtained in maths by 60 students has been given. Now you can see all these numbers. There are varieties of numbers given here. And if we represent this data in the form of frequency distribution table, then we will get too many rows. So as here we are having different types of entry, what we have to do, we have to group the numbers. Like you can see here, the group have been done. Here we are having the group like 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60. Now we have to make the entry. Like number 1, we are having 21. So where is 21? You can see here we are having the group 20 to 30 and 21 comes between 20 to 30. So here you will mark 1 tally in the group of 20 to 30. Similarly, if we take the number 19, 19 comes between the 10 and 20. So you will mark the tally of 19 in the group of 10 to 20. Similarly, if you take the number 48, 48 comes in between 40 and 50. So you will mark 1 tally of 48 in the group of 40 to 50. Similarly, you have to make the entry for all the given data. Now, you can see here what we have done. We have make or formed groups, small groups of the given data. And this kind of arrangement or representation is called grouped frequency distribution. Now, let us see the terms which are associated in group frequency distribution. See, in this given example, we have seen groups like 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and so on. See, all these groups are called class intervals. Now, if we take any one group, say 10 to 20, you can see 10 is written first. It is called the lower class limit, and 20 is the upper class limit. Similarly, if we take the group 20 to 30, 20 is the lower class limit and 30 will be the upper class limit. And the difference between upper class limit and the lower class limit is the size of class interval, or you can call it as the width of class. Now, here if I take the difference between the upper class limit and lower class limit, say of the group 10 to 20, so it will be 20 minus 10, that is equal to 10. So the size of this class or this group is 10. Now you can see here I have written one note. It says lower class limit is included but upper class limit is not included. It means if we are having an entry which is equal to your upper class limit, then we will not going to include that entry in that given group. We are going to make the entry in the next group. Now, let us understand this with the help of an example. Now, here you see in the previous frequency distribution table, we are having the group like 0 to 10, 10 to 20. But you see here in the given data, we are having one entry as 10. But you see here in the group, there is one 10 and here is also one 10. So where we are going to put this entry of 10? Now see, this 10 is equal to the upper class limit of this group. So we are not going to include 10 in this group. We are going to include 10 in the next group, that is in 10 to 20. So you are going to make the entry of 10 in 10 to 20 group. Similarly, if we take the number 50, now you see here also we are having 40 to 50 and 50 to 60. Now in the group 40 to 50, 50 is the upper class limit. So we are not going to write 50 in this group. We are going to include 50 in the group of 50 to 60. Now student, when you are going to form or make this group frequency distribution table, this thing you have to keep it in your mind. Now on page number 73, we are having this question in the try this column. Question number 1 says, study the following frequency distribution table and answer the question given below. So here the distribution table has been given. First column is of class interval and second column is of frequency. Now the question says, what is the size of class interval? Just now we have learned that the difference between the upper class limit and the lower class limit is the size of the class interval. So what we are going to do, we are going to simply subtract these two numbers, that is 125 minus 100, which is equal to 25. So your answer will be 25. Now question number 2 says, which class has the highest frequency? Now you see in the column of frequency, the greatest number is 140, and 140 is for the group or class interval 200 to 225. So your answer will be 200 to 225. Similarly, you are going to do all the questions of question number 1. Now let us see the next question, that is question number. Now in question number 2, we have construct a frequency distribution table for the data on weights of 20 students of a class using intervals 30 to 35, 35 to 40 and so on. And here are the data on weights. Now, to form a group frequency distribution table, you have to make three columns. One is of class interval, second is of tally mark, and third is of frequency. Now, class interval, we have to write the groups. Groups has been given as 30 to 35, 35 to 40. So, you will form the group like 30 to 35, 35 to 40, 40 to 45 and so on. Now, how many groups will be formed? Now, you see here in the entries, 65 is the greatest number. So, you have to form the group till 65 to 70. Now, you have to make the entries. First is 40. So, where you are going to place 40? Will you place it in the group of 35 to 40 or 40 to 45? You see, here in this group, 40 is the upper class limit. So, we are not going to include 40 in the group of 35 to 40. We will place 40 in the group of 40 to 45. So, here you will put one tally mark. Similarly, 38 is in the group of 35 to 40. So, you will put one tally for it. Again, next is 33. 33 is in the group of 30 to 35. So, you will put one mark of tally. Similarly, you have to do all the entries of the given data. Now, this two question of try this, you are going to do it in your graph book. Now, student, I hope you are cleared with group frequency distribution table. Now, let us move on to the exercise. After doing this try this, you will solve this question number 2 and 3 of exercise 5.1 in your graph book. Question number 2 says you have to make a frequency distribution table using tally mark, as well as you have to draw a bar graph for the same given data. So, I think you can do question number 2 of your own. Similarly, question number 3 says you have to form a group frequency table using the interval 800 to 810, 810 to 820 and so on. So, these two questions, you are going to do it in your graph book of your own. Now, students, I am stopping here and you will note down all the important terms which I have given in this video. Then you will solve the given try this as well as question number 2 and 3 of exercise 5.1 in your graph book. Till then, thank you. Namah Shivaya.